In the last video, we covered the anatomy of the dural sinuses. Now, let's go ahead and cover the rest of the veins you will find supplying the structures of the brain. So in this video, we're first going to talk about the cerebral veins, which include the deep cerebral veins and the superficial cerebral veins. Then, we will talk briefly about the diploic veins and the emissary veins. And again, in the previous video, we talked about the dural sinuses. So if that topic is unfamiliar to you, I'll put a link to a playlist that covers the venous drainage of different parts of their body. Alright, so the easiest way to understand the veins of the systemic circulation is to divide them into their own systems. So the veins of the heart form their own system. We have the veins of the inferior vena cava, which is responsible for supplying the lower half of the body. Veins of the superior vena cava for the upper half of the body. And the portal system, which drains nutrition from the intestines and waste products from the spleen, and then dump them into the liver to be processed, which then flow into the inferior vena cava again. So these are the four main systems of veins we have in our body. And so the cerebral veins are a part of the superior vena cava because they drain into it eventually. So here are the dural sinuses that we went through last time, all the main dural sinuses that exist in our brain. Let's expand on that and make a cross-section right across the cranium, as you see here, remove the upper half, and look at the skull from this perspective. We will see this. From this perspective, we can see the straight sinus, the transverse sinus, the sigmoid sinus, the inferior petrosal sinus and the superior petrosal sinus, the cavernous sinus, and between them there's the anterior and the posterior intercavernous sinus. And then there's the basilar plexus and the sphenoparietal sinus. And then here we see the tentorium cerebelli, which lies between the cerebellum and the cerebrum. Alright, so let's work from there and start breaking down the cerebral veins. The first thing that we need to know is that the cerebral veins have no valves, unlike the veins of the systemic circulation, which are equipped with valves to prevent the backflow of blood. The cerebral veins have no valves, just like the dural sinuses. Another thing is that the cerebral veins lie in the subarachnoid space. So here we see a coronal section of the brain. Here's the dural sinus, or the superior sagittal sinus, which lies in the space between the two layers of the dura mater. And here's the subarachnoid space, which contain the cerebral veins, as you see here, draining into the dural sinuses. And lastly, it's classified into the deep cerebral veins and the superficial cerebral veins. The deep cerebral veins drain blood from the diencephalon and the deep parts of the hemispheres into the great cerebral veins. I'll show you a scheme in a few seconds. The superficial cerebral veins collect blood from the cerebral cortex and drain the blood into the venous sinuses. Awesome! Let's work from there, starting with the deep cerebral veins. First on our list is the great cerebral vein. It's about 1 centimeter long, it's unpaired, and it opens into the straight sinus. Then let's add the hypothalamus, because this vein has tributary veins called the basal veins, which run underneath the hypothalamus and drains the hypothalamus and the basal nuclei. The basal vein is formed at the anterior perforating substance at the region of the midbrain, and it's formed by the union of some small anterior cerebral veins that go together with the anterior cerebral artery to supply or drain the medial surface of the frontal lobe. It do have some other tributaries as well, like the deep middle cerebral vein and the inferior striatal vein. But the most important here in CAPS is the anterior cerebral vein. Awesome. Next, let's build on this model and add the thalami, the lateral ventricles, as well as the third ventricle. The next vein is the internal cerebral vein. This one is located above the roof of the third ventricle, and it collects blood from the basal ganglia and the internal capsule and the choroid plexus and all those structures in this region. And it does that mainly through three veins that drain into it. Now, lateral to the lateral ventricle, we got the caudate nucleus. And the first vein that drains into the internal cerebral vein is the superior thalamostriatal vein. This vein curves anteriorly like this and drains blood from the thalamus, the striatum, and the internal capsule. Next, we have a vein that drains the choroid plexus of the lateral ventricles called the superior choroidal vein. Then we have the anterior vein of the septum pellucidum, which drain blood from the septum pellucidum and the head of the caudate nucleus. So that was all the deep cerebral veins that I wanted to cover. Let's quickly recap those now before we go over to the superficial ones. So here we see the superior sagittal sinus and the inferior sagittal sinus. Between them we see the straight sinus, which forms the confluence of sinuses. Then we have the occipital sinus, the transverse sinus, the sigmoid sinus, and the internal jugular vein. We get the superior and the inferior petrosal sinuses, which drain from the cavernous sinus. We got the sphenoparietal sinus and the intercavernous sinus. Then we have the basilar plexus, which drains several surrounding structures around it. Here we have the hypothalamus, the lateral and the third ventricle, right and the left thalamus, the caudate nucleus, and the choroid plexus. Here we have the great cerebral vein, which continues as the basal vein and receives blood from the anterior cerebral vein. We have the internal cerebral vein, which receives blood from the superior thalamostriatal vein, superior choroid vein, and the anterior vein of the septum pellucidum. Awesome. So that was all the main veins that drain the inner gray matter and white matter of the cerebral hemispheres. Let's now briefly talk about the superficial cerebral veins. So again, here we have the superior sagittal sinus, occipital sinus, the transverse sinus, and the sigmoid and the internal jugular. We have the superior and the inferior petrosal sinuses and the cavernous sinus. Cool. So again, the superficial cerebral veins drain blood from the cerebral cortex into these sinuses we see here. And there are four main ones that's important to know here. The first one is the superficial middle cerebral vein. This is a vein that's visible superficially when you look at the brain grossly. It begins close to the supramarginal gyrus, and then it runs anteriorly along the lateral cerebral sulcus, as you see here, and then it drains into the sphenoparietal or the cavernous sinus in the front here. And it mainly drains the lobes around it, so the frontal lobe and the parietal lobe and the temporal lobe. Now there are two important anastomotic branches here called the superior anastomotic vein of Trolland, which is a connection between the superficial middle cerebral vein and the superior cerebral veins of the superior sagittal sinus, and the inferior anastomotic vein of Labbe, or however you pronounce it, which is a connection between the superficial middle cerebral vein and the inferior cerebral vein of the transverse sinus. Then we have a lot of veins that connect blood from the superior lateral surface of the cortex and drain into mainly the superior sagittal sinus. And similarly, we have the inferior cerebral veins, which drain the inferior part of the cerebral cortex and empty the blood into the transverse, superior petrosal, and the inferior petrosal sinuses. Next, we have the superior and the inferior cerebellar veins, which are also called the infratentorial veins because they're located below the tentorium cerebelli. So here we have the cerebellum, and these are the superior and the inferior cerebellar veins. So they drain blood from the cerebellum and flow into the closest sinus, which are the superior and the inferior petrosal sinuses, the sigmoid sinus, and the transverse sinus. So that was all I had for the cerebral veins. Awesome. Let's now talk briefly about the diploic veins. Diploic veins lie in the diploe and drains them. So remember from bone histology that the diploe is a spongious bony tissue between the external and the internal layers of the skull. So here's the skull. Take one piece out and it will look like this. The inner and the outer surface are covered by a periosteum, just like the rest of the bones in our body. The outer and the inner part are compact bone, and in here you will find a spongy bone, which is called the diploe. Now take a look at this model here. Where do you think the diploic veins are? They're here. I know you got this one right. They're some very small veins located inside the spongy part of the skull, and they mainly drain the blood into the venous sinuses on the inside and can even communicate with the external veins of the skull sometimes. So that's the diploic veins. Next, we have the emissary veins. The emissary veins are veins that connect the dural sinuses and the extracranial veins. So in other words, they form the craniocerebral anastomoses. Here's an extracranial vein, Here's the dural sinus, and here's the foramina of the skull. Inside the foramina, you will find the emissary veins. And don't forget that we also have the diploic veins here. So there are four main emissary veins that we need to mention. If we add the skull here, remember we had the superficial temporal vein? The first emissary vein is called the parietal emissary vein, which runs through the parietal foramen, connecting the superior sagittal sinus with the superficial temporal vein. Then we have the occipital vein, and the next emissary vein is called the mastoid emissary vein, which runs through the mastoid foramen, connecting the sigmoid sinus with the occipital vein. Then we have the occipital emissary vein, which runs through the occipital foramen, connecting the transverse sinus and the confluence of sinuses with the occipital vein. Then we got the external vertebral venous plexus, which is connected with the sigmoid sinus through the condylar emissary veins. So that was everything I had for the cerebral, diploic, and the emissary veins. If you found this video helpful, please put a like, share, comment, whatever you find convenient to you. See you next time.